I'm Gene Grant here in the studios of New Mexico PBS with our line opinion panelists. Now, we're getting ready to dive into this week's show, but like we always like to do, we like to begin with a topic to get us a little warmed up here. Now, this week, we had a lot of important topics on the table, up for possible discussion, but since we don't have time for all of them, we want to take a minute to just highlight some of them. Martha Burke, let me start with you. A lot of things catch your eye every week. I'm sure it's hard to pick one, but what's caught your eye?
Oh, I picked one this week. Yeah. It got me pretty warm, as you might say. There's a bill that's been introduced, it was pre-filed actually, by Miguel Garcia, proposing a state holiday in honor of Ben Chavez, who was a U.S. Senator from the 30s to the 60s, and Cesar Chavez. And he has made the statement accompanying the bill that no other person associated with New Mexico has done as much as these two men.
Oh, wow.
Well, what about Dolores Huerta? She is a native New Mexican, a daughter of Dawson, New Mexico, born here in the 30s.
Right.
She preceded Cesar Chavez by several years, forming the organization that became the United Farm Workers. And Representative Garcia has totally ignored that. I hope he'll read a history book.
That's interesting. Maybe he's watching. He'll think about that a little bit. Not that those other folks are not worthy, but come on.
No, I think I'm suggesting he just needs to change it to the Dolores Huerta, Ben Chavez, and Cesar Chavez holiday.
There's a solution right there. I love that. Tom Garrity, what have you been seeing out there?
Well, T.J. Trout and his return to the Albuquerque airwaves after a hiatus. You know, in full disclosure, I only listen to the podcast that's available online, but Cumulus has brought him back and on the 770 radio show. And I have to say, in this age of afflicted partisanship, it's really kind of nice to hear T.J. Trout get in there and just, you know, be right in the middle very soundly, you know, taking jabs one at one end and at the other. The interview that I was listening to was his interview of Gary Johnson.
Yes.
And it was almost as if the two of them had not missed a single step.
I agree.
Going back and forth. So it was very entertaining. So I'm just because, T.J. Trout always calls it like he sees it.
That's right.
And, you know, the only agenda he has is his own. I like that show. So I'm glad
he's back. It's a nice, brave move. I just preceded Gary Johnson in the hour before, and interestingly, I think it's a bold move by Cumulus. It's a very interesting move when you think about it, because it's following Rush Limbaugh. I mean, TJ has, you know, obviously carved out a thing for himself here, but using humor to attack some of these problems we have in our culture right now. It's a very interesting approach. I think he's going to do well with it.
Yeah, hope so.
Good stuff, yeah. Eric Riego, what have you been seeing out there?
Well, you know, I was struck this week by, you know, now that we have, for the first time in history, two Native American women in Congress, that our new Congresswoman, you know, kind of weighed in, not in a hyperbolic way, but in a very, I think, to use her term, you know, a voice they hadn't heard about the importance of, regardless of what you believe in this whole scenario with the Washington, the Covington kids and so on, just to say that in our, especially in our culture, that a young man with a very controversial hat to stare down an elder, especially a Native elder, is just, you know, I think we have to be honest about, like, I would be embarrassing, even if, God forbid, I was a MAGA person. But I just like to think if that kid were happened to be wearing a Black Lives Matter hat or something like that, what the reaction would have been to him sort of confronting an elder of any community, especially a veteran, a Vietnam veteran. So I'm glad that she really sort of, I think it was pretty measured, like she was very disappointed, and that we have to really have an honest conversation about what respect means, regardless of what your political views are.
What did you make of the spin machine that spun out of that situation? It didn't take long. We've got, you know, folks on both sides. The president has weighed in. I mean, what did you make of that? Were the lessons lost here in the spin?
Well, I think it just is sadly testament to the polarization that we have in the country right now. When you have a leader who really sort of stokes these fires, I mean, he could have, again, missed opportunity for him to step in the middle and said, wait a minute, look, you know, there were some folks there who were really saying some terrible things to these kids.
Right.
And you know, any of us would not want our sons to be, you know, in the face of an elder wearing a pretty, you know, pretty polarizing hat. I mean, you know, like, and so I just think we're in this environment, this new world order, where it's so incredibly, everything is so politically charged.
I don't think any of us would want our sons to be there, and I don't think any of us would have hired a PR firm to get him out.
Good point. Good point.
Interesting. Justine, how do you follow that? What's been catching your eye this week?
Well, speaking of a politically charged environment and more encounters on the streets, I've been watching the city of Albuquerque, Mayor Keller's recent appointment, creation of the Office of Civil Rights.
Yes.
And I think, you know, there's been sort of a quiet waiting to see if there are culture changes at the police department and within the city. There was an initial furor when Damon Martinez came over, you know, having been involved with DOJ and this potential restructuring consent decree. So I'm hoping for substantive change at the city. And I think it's been interesting that the mayor has received a lot of accolades, you know, on this Office of Civil Rights. But I don't know that we've really seen real substantive change yet.
Do you feel it's an unnecessary position? Or am I hearing you correctly on that? Or
I think it may be something of a response to an outcry for change, but it's got to be more than just sort of a figurehead.
Right.
You know, we really need to get into the ranks at APD and change that culture. It's hard for a civilian to do, so maybe it's unnecessary. We'll see. But I'm hoping that it's a sign that maybe something's going to change. But, Keller didn't back off on Damon Martinez.
That's
even
right.
When there was an outcry from the NAACP
and
others. And so I think the press has kind of given him a pass on that. And I'd just like to see some change.
Good points. Fair enough. Now we'll have to wrap that up. We'll see you next time.